A lot of what we did on that album was we did bring a lot of different records together. It was a competition almost. Like DJing and hip hop is competitive anyway. So I would bring in a record and go, okay, yeah, okay, we're gonna loop that up. Posse will come in, yeah, but what about this? Then Dave Trugoy would come in, yeah, but I think this would be good. Then Mace go, ah, that's all right, but how about this? All right, let's put them all together. You know what I'm saying? And that's how I think the record came out really, really, I guess, different as far as production.
We followed all the requirements to hand in sample clearances and make sure things were dealt with. Tommy Boy was in control of the administration. All we had to do was fill out the forms and hand them in. But they were in control of the administration, so they felt like certain things like transmitting live from Mars was insignificant to clear because it was such just a small skit. Who's going to really pay attention to something so silly as that? Well, that was the very first thing that came to bite us. There was a public lawsuit out there from the Turtles for $1 million. We settled out of court for $50,000. Due to our miscommunication, whatever the shuffle was, we end up going half with Tommy Boy on the bill.
Because the record got popular, what happened was the label didn't know that the record was going to get that popular. I mean, Tommy Boy hasn't had a hit record since Planet Rock. And meanwhile, it's 1989. You know what I'm saying? So they, I guess they were like, oh, this is just like any other record. You know, I mean, not any other record, but, you know, yeah, we put out albums before. It's going to sell. Psst. I remember them saying, like, yeah, it'll probably sell like 100,000 copies, if that. You know what I'm saying? The record did a lot more than anybody expected. So that's when the lawsuits came in, and the label really wasn't prepared for it.
There was a point in time where different people didn't want you to sample. Like, there was a time Anita Baker didn't want anybody to touch her stuff. George Benson didn't want anybody to touch their stuff. Steely Dan didn't want anybody to touch his stuff, but he didn't realize we touched his stuff. That's how obscure we were doing things as well. Now, he didn't even realize that we used his record, but we made it clear. Because at the same time, we're a fan of the people that we sampled from. A lot of that music we truly are into. We grew up on that. You know, so to want to give the proper credit, that's something we aspired to do. You know, sampling became a significant business.
The main focus was not money. It was just the quality of the music. So regardless of what we sampled or regardless of the lawsuits, it was the final outcome is what was more important. Because we didn't go in that record thinking like, wow, we're going to make this unique record, and we're going to sell all these units, and we're going to, you know, be rich beyond our wildest dreams. It was the fact that we stand for a certain thing, and that was to be yourself. And that was what that whole album was about. It was not to rebel against all that gold and all the other things that were, I guess, kind of cliched as hip-hop back then. It was just like, this is where we come from, and this is our style. And that's the only thing we was trying to put across. And hopefully, yeah, we'll get a show or two out of it and, you know, maybe make a dollar or two, but that was never the focus. It was always has been the music.